Hello and welcome to Crux Investor. We're caught up with Alberto Orozco. He's the CEO of Capitan Mining. Now, Alberto's brought a team of people that he's worked with for the last 16 years together to develop the Capitan Project. We've also got additional silver projects, Jesus Maria, which has thrown up some very interesting silver grades. Also, involvement of Mike Gentile, who is a seasoned investor on projects like this. This is open pit heap leach project, something that the team's very well versed in. We're intrigued by how they're planning to spend their $4 million and what the drill results are showing so far. So if you want our thoughts and opinions on the conversation and the company itself, you can find that at cruxinvestor.com. We'd also love your feedback, so give us a like, leave your comments below. And if you want to see precisely what we talked about today, do take a look in the description. Alberto, how are you, sir?
Great, man. How are you?
Fantastic. Now, we bumped into each other at one of those Mexican mining conferences and a panel about doing business in Mexico, didn't we? About 2 months ago?
That's correct. Yeah, that was, so you moderated the Mexico as a jurisdiction panel.
Yeah. That was good. That was fun. There's some fun people.
That was a good one.
Yeah. Hey, well, like, thanks for joining us today. Let's start with this. So where are you today?
I'm in Hermosillo, Mexico. It'll be a nice 40 degrees in a couple of minutes here.
Oh, really? So what time is it? It's early. We're early.
It's only 9 o'clock, but it'll be 40 in 15 minutes or so.
Wow. Yeah. Wow. Okay. That's brutal. Looking forward to learning about Capitan Mining today. So it's new to me, you know, obviously apart from the conference, we've not spoken before, I've not heard the story, so I'm very much looking forward to this. I'm going to start by asking for the customary 1 minute overview of your business, and I'll pick it up from there with some questions.
Sure. Well, Capitan is a new company focused on gold and silver exploration in Mexico. We currently have the Peñoles Project in the state of Durango, which is a great jurisdiction in Mexico to be exploring. It's a project where the Peñoles company was born. That's where the original mines for the Peñoles company were located. It has an initial resource of about 500,000 ounces gold equivalent, with a gold and a silver component to that. Open in every direction, still early in the discovery process and the resource building process, with a number of other really high quality targets in the property. And with a great team that has done this in the past a number of times.
Okay, brilliant. Appreciate that. Okay, so we're in Mexico. We're gold, we're silver. It's early days. You've also recently raised some money, so you're fully funded for what you want to do, or certainly the next phase of what you want to do. I want to take you back a bit, which I always do with news stories, is just trying to understand the business plan. What did you set out to do? And it's always quite good to start with your track record. Who are you? What have you done? And maybe tell me a little bit about the team, and then we'll get on to the project.
Absolutely. And we think this is a big part of the Capitan story, our track record and the team. We have been able to put together a team that has been working together for three companies before Capitan. And so over the last 16 years, we've been putting this group together. We started back with Linear Gold some 16 years ago, then on to Pediman Gold, then on to Argonaut, where we worked 8 to 9 years there together, working on very similar projects, developing these projects, sometimes at an early stage, recognizing the value early on, and then taking them all the way into construction and production. So we've worked with the operating projects as well.
Okay, and what did you do there? Where are the similarities in terms of the stage of the project, but also in terms of the value that you then went on to create?
Well, this project, like many that we had both in Pediment and Argonaut at the time, has an initial resource, in this case, an inferred resource. That was the case for a number of the projects we had back then as well. But we saw the value beyond that resource that was stated. We knew that there was additional ground to explore, that it was clear that the geology was solid and there was still more to discover, and that could resource could be grown into something more meaningful. But also that those were projects that had a strong chance of becoming a mine. We like projects that are real, not just projects that have some, you know, random or some geological potential. We like projects that are real, that have not only that potential to grow resources, but also are in a good jurisdiction, good area, have good potential for community relations or a good history with the community. And we see all of that in the Peñoles project.
Right, okay. Well, tell me a little bit more about who does what on the team, because I recognize a couple of the names there, Jean-Marc, obviously, from the Riverside guys. But who does what? I mean, what are you bringing to the table?
Sure. So let me briefly mention our board. Arturo Bonillas is a very well-known mine operator in Mexico, so he brings that expertise and the ability also to say, okay, yes, I believe in this becoming a mine. That's really good to have Arturo's experience in our board. Jean-Marc is an explorer and has been in Mexico since the 80s. He knows pretty much the entire country and he knows potential in a project when he sees it. Myself, I've been involved in all stages from the early discovery, the development, the construction, and the operations. And I've even been involved as well in the, let's say, the corporate affairs, the external affairs, the government relations. That's something I think we're very important that distincts Capitan from other companies, that we have not only the technical capability, but we also have a strong network within the country that is key to advancing projects.
Yeah, and you've worked a lot. In fact, I know this from the conference as well. We talked about the ability to do business in Mexico, you know, long history for sure. Which state are you in?
I live in Sonora State. Our project is located in Durango State. Both, by the way, really on my top list of jurisdictions in Mexico.
Yeah, for sure. For sure. Okay, well, maybe let's get back to the project proper then, because I want to understand what it is that you're setting out to try and do. I guess you're going to try and replicate some of the success that you've seen in country before. But just lay it out for us. So business plan is what?
Yeah, so when we started looking at the Peñoles project early on, we recognized this potential we were just talking about. So what we wanted to do was sort of apply that same recipe, that same work program that we have done with other projects, and try to expand this. First of all, we believe that the first resource estimate done by previous operators was very premature, was very early. And so we first want to get this as an expanded inferred resource, particularly in the gold zone, because we have a gold and a silver zone to the project, to the resource. We see the potential to grow that gold zone very quickly, very effectively. And that's our main focus currently, to expand that near surface gold, open pittable potentially resource in that area before we move later on into a PEA for the project.
So why do you say it was premature? Just because it's got a small number on it, or because they didn't actually work out the extent of the ore? But I mean, why do you use that phrasing?
It's basically that you just mentioned, that we saw that there was very good continuity to the geology here, and the drilling was just not enough. It was very little drilling, only 10,000 meters in the resource. That's not a lot. That's really very little. We've seen projects with 100,000 meters that have, you know, 1 to 2 million ounce resources. Here we have 10,000 meters and 500,000 gold equivalent inferred resource. And that's a very good success rate. But looking at the continuity of the geology in all its dimensions, on strike, down dip, through its width, we just knew that the potential for finding more was very, very good, was great. And we wanted to do that again. And, you know, we did that in the past with a number of projects as well that we worked on. And with our current drill program, we've been delivering on that thesis. We've been really confirming that is indeed more continuity to this mineralized body at the Capitan zone. And it continues to be open.
But I want to come back. I want to come back to the drilling in a second. But I'm more interested in the decision making about, given that you look at a variety of different options out there, some with, you know, much larger resources available to them. You picked this one with 10,000 meter drilling. I'm hearing. What else? Because that's kind of, must give you a low level of confidence, surely, with not a lot of data. More data is better.
More data is better. But when you have this level of success with that little drilling, that's really good. I mean, that's really what you're looking for. I mean, you can have 10,000 meters of drilling and have one hit or two hits. In this case, all of those drill holes hit on mineralization, were able to give you a very good size resource. And we just saw the potential to continue expanding that.
Right, but what other data, apart from the drilling, there must be more data available to you?
Yeah, absolutely. We saw that this was a historical mining site. This is where the Peñoles company was born. Two, there was extensive mapping and sampling that had been done in the project before. We haven't been talking about our other targets yet, only about the resource area, but we saw that as well. There was trenching, there was underground sampling, mapping. So we knew that it was not only what those drill holes had identified, it was the entire package of information that we evaluated.
Right, so this is a case of, let's pick up a nice cheap asset, we'll see what we can do. The data leads you to believe, because you're hitting on mineralization on the holes that you're looking at, you're comfortable with that. What's it remind you of? Is this?
It was actually really reminiscent of our neighboring projects to the south, El Castillo and San Agustin, where our team worked for a number of years. So from the first time that we started evaluating the data, it was very reminiscent of that. In the style of mineralization, the geology, that was also part of what got us excited about this project, because you know we had seen two other projects very close by, only an hour and a half drive away, that had been successes for another company, you know, generating cash, becoming operating mines today. And we saw all of those elements in the Peñoles project as well.
Alberto, let me just ask you about drilling, though. We've seen some press releases come out. Talk to me about the results that you got versus what you were expecting to see. And I say this in the context of you've got data, you want to prove out a bigger resource clearly, but you've got to go about it a certain way. You're not looking for headlines. You're trying to do it the right way, it seems to me. So, What should we be looking at with regards to those drill results?
Yeah, you're exactly right there. We're looking, you know, we're really exploring and reporting as we go. What we have been seeing with our drill results, it's one, consistency with the geology, the model that had been laid out before, that continuity. We've continued to extend that original zone. But we've also discovered or identified a very meaningful zone that we call the hanging wall zone. That's something additional that has been growing significantly in the project. That's roughly new. I mean, it was there before, but now we've identified it to be more important and larger than previously expected. And we're also seeing, you know, some other targeting ideas now coming from higher silver sometimes in within the gold zone, and sometimes even higher grades as well. So as we've been developing this, yes, we've been expanding sort of the model that we started out with, but we're also recognizing that there are other geological features here that will add meaningfully to a new resource estimate.
But how do you go about doing that? Because we've talked recently in the market about companies doing step out programs, right? And some people don't step out too far because they don't want a nasty little headline or results. So how do you go about planning that in the context of truly trying to understand contained metal in the ground versus what the market wants to hear?
Well, with our approach, we are not doing very long step outs because we see that potential to grow there with what we have immediate to the zone. But we do see some very large gaps in what was drilled before. We drilled some of those. We've been drilling on strike extensions, sometimes going at a 50 or 100 meter step outs at a time, as well as down dip. And we've been hitting on every hole, which is very exciting as well.
Right, I'm intrigued, because you've raised, I think it was about $3.2 million or so. You must have walked into that with an idea of what you wanted to do with that in terms of confirming what it is that you thought you had, right? So what's the plan?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, first, with our first round of drilling, we were able to add another 6,000 meters to the project. You have to keep in mind there's 10,000 in total, but 7,000 of those were in the Capitan area. So we nearly doubled the amount of drilling at the Capitan gold zone. With the capital we raised, that puts us at roughly about $4 million in cash in the treasury. That can take us a long way. We can potentially double the amount of drilling that we've done already in the first phase and continue expanding the mineralization at Capitan and start to test as well our other targets, not only within the resource, but in the other targets that we have within the project.
You're going to spend, I don't know what part of the $4 million you're going to spend on, one, expanding the Capitan,
the data that you've got at Capitan, and then you got a little bit of, you know, playing around the edges here. What was the market going to be thinking at that point when you're going to present whatever you present to the market?
I think most of that goes into Capitan. We're currently working into how we're going to lay out. We're currently working on our guidance. We are finalizing our evaluation of the first 6,000 meters of drilling that we did. You know, we're putting that into models, finalizing our second phase exploration program for the area. Probably most of that is of our new budget is going to go into the Capitan area, where we continue to see the potential for growth there. It continues to be open after this initial stage of mineralization. So most of that, most of the budget is going to go probably there. But we will also want to start testing the higher grade silver zone in Jesus Maria, which is just immediately adjacent to the north. We will probably also want to test the San Rafael area with some drilling. San Rafael is an area to the northeast, also with a historical mine. Five historical drill holes, not part of the resource, but all hit mineralization. So that's another area where we think there's good potential for adding ounces. And then also maybe drill testing some of our targets to the south as well.
Okay, but here's one for you. We interviewed a guy called Mike Gentile last week. You know him?
I know him, yeah.
big shareholder, right? So even before you come to the market, you're going to have to impress that guy. We were quite impressed with him, actually, I have to say. You know, he doesn't make these sorts of investments lightly, and he's very aggressive and very confident about what he wants to deliver with them. So what was he saying to you? What were you saying to him in terms of the way you go about creating value in this scenario with what you've got here?
Sure. Well, first of all, we're very excited to have Michael as a strategic investor into the company. I think that's a testament of the high quality project and team that we have. And he tends to focus on things that have a real chance of becoming something. Really, that's been part of the conversation. He believes in the team, in the track record that the team has, in us being able to recognize a good project, and that, you know, also what we were mentioning in the beginning, that with not a whole lot of drilling, the previous operators were able to put together this resource with that great continuity that we were observing, that potential. I think all those elements come together. In the end, I think Capitan is a story about a real asset. I mean, we're not talking about fantasy here. We see something that has a real chance of becoming an operating mine in the future. And I think that's what Michael sees as well.
Yeah, I think so. I mean, we did talk about briefly, which is why we're obviously talking now, is I like his fundamentals approach to investing. He's not investing in a promotional idea. He's investing in a company which has got legs, which is why I mentioned sort of pushing you on the number side of things and how you move from what you've got now to the next stage. So you've got a team. You've worked in Mexico. You've done it before, is it three times you're telling me?
Three companies, and in all of three companies, you know, we've generated a plus 1 million ounce resource.
Right. Is that the game? Is that the game plan here? To get to 1 million and check out, or is there more to it?
No, that's definitely our goal in the short term. Obviously, we can't guarantee or mention that we will, but that's definitely our goal. And when you look at, you know, I'll let you do your own numbers, but we're starting out of 500,000 gold equivalent resource, how we've been expanding the mineralization at the Capitan zone. We have not yet tested the silver. I think 1 million ounce resource, inferred resource, is a reasonable goal. We have done it in other projects, but the project has potential for more. I think it definitely has potential to grow larger than that. That will be later on in the development history of the project, but I think that's definitely our short-term goal.
Okay, so get to 1 million ounces, what, do some kind of study, PEA, potentially.
Yeah, first is to expand the inferred resource. Now, that's our first goal. That's where we want to. We believe there's the higher bang for the buck with our drilling. And then we'll continue to refine that resource and obviously do some more work around that in the area to get that to a PEA and show what the true value of the Peñoles project is.
So that's what this team does. And that's what Mike Gentile is happy with. Get to a PEA and then see who wants it.
Exactly. That we have done that a number of times with the team, expand resources, then move to PEAs. We have been fortunate as well to work in development and to be around the construction and operations of the projects. So if that's a route we have to go at some point with the team, then we have the ability and the network to do it. But let's say our most immediate goal is to expand this resource and then to show that, you know, a positive PEA comes out of that.
Okay. So right now, today, you own 100% of that asset. There's no other payments due. All good from...
We own it 100%.
Okay. Fantastic. So in terms of moving things forward, in terms of outstanding permits or anything to do with, well, because we talked about this in the conference, you've got to get your paperwork right. You've got to do things properly as well. So, you know, what are the long poles in the tent? What are the things that are going to hold you back?
Well, right now we are fully permitted for our exploration moving forward for the next year or so. We are fully permitted. It could even extend beyond that. Once you start looking into putting things into production, then you go into a different permitting process. Now, we're not leaving that for later. You know, we're starting early with getting the right consultants, setting the right foundation so that we can build that very systematically moving forward. We want to be very strategic about how we move this project forward. So we want to start from the very beginning thinking about how we're going to get this permitted in the end for a mine as well.
Right. So and again, I just want to be clear on the exit. I want to know what I'm walking into here. You guys take it through to PEA and you look for a buyer. Would that be an asset sale or would that be the company? Because what's the opportunity for you guys to go and find the next asset or the next couple of assets and do the same thing? So how are you planning it?
Well, you know, there are a number of opportunities in Mexico and in other jurisdictions. I wouldn't say they're all gone. There's certainly a number of them still around. We are looking for some of them. If the right one comes along and it's the right fit for Capitan, then you know, we might do something. But there are other opportunities around. I don't think we necessarily want to stay a single asset company. There are other assets that are high quality. And if it's the right opportunity for Capitan, we might move forward on some of those.
Right. I'm trying to understand it. Is Capitan around for the long term, or are we just sitting in this little PA and then we have to find the next company or not?
No, we have a long-term vision, and I think our investors do too. Michael Gentili certainly has a long-term vision with the companies he invests in. We're not here for the short run. We're here to transform this into a reality and to develop it as much as we can moving forward to its full potential.
So to take this the right way, is it easier for a Mexican, like a completely 100% Mexican management team and a 50% Mexican board to do business in Mexico than it would be for a Canadian team?
Yes, absolutely. And in country too, because I live here as well. And being here with our team 100% Mexican, it really, you know, makes you advance things faster. You don't have to jump any cultural hurdles. Sometimes communication can be very key. In the past, you know, I saw a lot of companies, you know, getting into confusing times or trouble because of those communication gaps. We don't have that. We have a team that's 100% in country. Our board, I would argue, is more than 50% Mexican, with only three directors, two of us Mexican and in Mexico. And John Mark is even 50% Mexican as well. So it's a 75% Mexican board.
This is true. I think he was on that panel as well. You've just basically brought the panel back together. That's what you've done. Okay, I understand. I'm excited about the story because, I'm excited about the team's relevant experience in country doing exactly the same thing. That's what I think is exciting. The asset you're going to have to, you know, prove out and prove up and move along the curve, as it were. So again, I look forward to staying in touch and seeing how you get on that front. Please pick up the phone. Let us know if there's anything interesting happening. I'll be delighted to take that phone call.
Well, thank you, Matt. Yeah, last I'd like to leave you with for Capitan moving forward is we will continue to work in the project. We believe that the target for 1 million ounces or 1 million ounces inferred resource gold equivalent is very real. We will continue to work on that, particularly focusing on the Capitan zone of the project. But one thing we haven't talked about is the Jesus Maria silver zone that it's immediately adjacent to the Capitan zone. There, the former operators intersected 7.15 meters of 988 grams per ton silver and 1.24 grams per ton gold. Those are some spectacular grades that you would see in other companies like Silvercrest, the Vizsla type of news releases. We have that in the Peñoles project as well. It's something that we will go on and drill in the near future. We're just focusing on more on the Capitan near surface potential. We also have other targets within the property that we want to drill. We're excited about those. We're generating some targeting work, some surface work to do that more effectively. But we will be touching on those probably later on this year as well. And, you know, we will keep our eyes open. We're very actively looking as well for other opportunities, particularly within Mexico, that might fit the Capitan strategy.